laughed and cried. I've had my fill.
You've got to be crazy if you want to change the world.
And now,
I won't give up.
Subside,
I know we can do this together.
I find it all so amusing to think.
It's a mercy to forget. Those were your words, Jack.
And may I say,
you're not off the hook just yet.
Oh, no.
The rest is up to Jack.
I did it.
Has the world changed for the better, Jack?
For what is a man? What has he got?
Goodbye, Jack.
Then he has not to say the things.
I'll never forget you.
You sure about that?
Of course I am. You never forget your first love.
Hi everybody, this is Kevin and welcome back to another video. And today I'm going to share my thoughts on Stranger of Paradise Final Fantasy Origin for the PS4, which is the game that I'd been hyped for ever since I saw the first trailer at last summer's E3. You know, the trailer with Jack saying, I have to destroy chaos! I must kill chaos! The darkness is so thick I can taste it! Among various other great quotes. And a lot of people were criticizing the trailer when it first came out, saying, oh my god, this is cringe. It looks like PS3 level graphics. Jack looks like Core from Final Fantasy 15, which he kind of does. Jed, he kind of looks like Prompto with pink hair, which he kind of does. But, you know, I was honestly hyped for it just because the trailer was like so crazy. I'm like, oh, we got to see what this is all about. Especially too, because it's from Tetsuya Nomura, the absolute madman, who also gets a lot of criticism. You know, some of it warranted, some of it, you know, come on, give the guy a break, will ya? I mean, he gets a lot of criticism for Kingdom Hearts, I think. But overall, I was very hyped for the game. And then, like, a few months later, they had released a demo. I wasn't able to play it because it was only exclusive to PS5, but I did see clips online, and I was like, oh, this looks pretty fucking cool. You got job classes, you got all this good stuff. You know, I think overall there's like 30 different job classes in this game. And then we got more trailers with different characters, with Astos, the Dark Elf, who really turned out to be my favorite character in the whole game. And then we eventually got the trailer with Frank Sinatra's My Way, which I just showed you a clip there. And, you know, we'll get the spoilers a little later, but you know, there's, I guess, some spoiler clips in that trailer. And, you know, the story in this game is actually really fucking good. I've seen some people who have beaten the game saying that, oh, the story, it takes away from the original Final Fantasy, which in the grand scheme of things, does the original Final Fantasy really have a story? I mean, it's, you know, you're the four warriors of light, go get the four crystals, defeat chaos, and save the world. I mean, the early Final Fantasy games really don't have much of a story. So I'm cool with them sort of doing their own spin on the original game and having it make somewhat more sense. I don't know, we'll get to that with a spoiler warning, but, you know, some people have said this is like a Neo clone, which it's done by the same people. I think, is it Koei Tecmo? It's Koei Tecmo and Team Ninja, along with Square Enix, of course. I've never played the Neo games. I'm really not a big action RPG fan. I'm mostly into turn-based games, but I have played my share of action RPGs. You know, mostly like the Kingdom Hearts games. I guess Final Fantasy VII Remake is in that category. Even Final Fantasy XV. But I mostly like turn-based games. So, you know, I bought this game alone just by watching the first trailer and, you know, having the Final Fantasy name to it. And, you know, it's very difficult. You know, it really is. You have to learn how to use the job classes properly. You can equip a main job and a sub job. And, you know, both job classes that you have equipped earn experience, but the main job earns more experience. And what I usually did is I had like a melee job as my primary, and then my secondary job I had a mage. Like, it's best to level up the black and the white mage, because once you max them out, you get access to the sage, which I think is the most powerful job class in the entire game, because you can use black and white magic. So, you know, you can just stand in the corner casting spells and healing and your buffs on the party, and then have your party members attack. So, You know, and I like the party, too. One little criticism, because you can only have three party members. You know, Jack's always there, then you have two other party members. And you start with Jed and Ash. And it's just hilarious how they meet. They're, like, walking into Cornelia. And they both sort of, like, grunt at each other. They're like, And they show each other they have the black crystals. And they're like, all right, let's go. We're here to kill chaos. It's just a hunger. I must kill chaos. And there's this hilarious view that I found on 4chan. It's in my folder somewhere. I should have looked before I did the video. But it's of the Giga Chad. Like, you may have seen that meme before. And it's got a caption of him saying, you know, me and my comrades want to kill fucking chaos. And then the king is like, oh, praise be. The gods have answered us. Let's send these homeless men to kill chaos. Which is so true. Because, you know, I love the banter. The characters have a lot of banter as you're walking through the dungeons, which are mostly linear. Like, you have a different path which you can take, which leads you to a treasure chest or an orb. And the orbs give you more context. It's like a data log. It gives you more, like, stuff you can read about the plot and what the deal is here. Why everyone is referred to as, the heroes anyway, are referred to as strangers. So then you eventually meet more party members. You meet Neon, who ends up actually, she's the first boss. You fight, like, the Dark Knight, who you think is Garland. But it turns out it's Neon. And it's just funny when Jack's fighting him, too. Or her, I should say. But, you know, at this point, we think it's him, because it's the Knight. And he's, like, punching Garland, and he's like, I'll crush you! And then the guy's eyes grow red. No, when you're beaten, like, just the dialogue is so fucking badass. And, like, every boss fight too, they'll have like a halfway point, and you want to use the stagger gauge to whittle the stagger gauge down so that you can press circle and just defeat the enemy with one hit, or at least trigger the next phase, because otherwise you're gonna be there for a while, especially against Tiamat, which is one of the most difficult of the early bosses. But you know, Neon joins your party, and then eventually when you face Tiamat, that turns out to be Sophia, or rather, Sophia's there, and then, you know, I'm getting ahead of myself. But yeah, she joins your party, and you have five party members, and you can only have two others in your party, which is kind of, I don't know, I don't like that. It would have been cooler if they could all be in your party, but I guess I kind of get it, because there'd be too many characters on the screen, and it already did have kind of buffering and lagging issues, so I don't know, maybe that's why. But yeah, I feel like the party members were all pretty useful. Like I said, for most of the boss fights, I kind of just sat in the corner using the sage powers, casting spells, and then, you know, telling the party members to attack. Like, if you use the D-pad, you can have them use more powerful attacks. So I'm going to cut right now to just showing you, like, the trophies, because I got the platinum in the game, and a little bit of gameplay footage, and then I'll come back and I'll do some spoiler discussion. So I'll be right back, guys. Okay, we're back over here. I'll show you my trophies. I got them all. So I'm playing Final Fantasy X-2 for streaming, and then I just started Persona 5 Royal, which is another great game. But the platinum is pretty easy to get in this game, because all of these trophies here are story-based up until A Fraught Journey. Okay? And then this one is bugged. Origin of True Chaos. It says complete the game on Chaos difficulty, but that's a lie. I think it's bugged, because what you have to do is you just have to beat one level on Chaos difficulty, which you unlock after you beat the game. So it's any mission on the hardest difficulty, which isn't bad at all. This one, I guess kind of, this is where I grinded at the end, because there's one trophy where you need to max out one of your job classes to level 99, because in the regular story, it goes up to 30, and then after you beat the game, you can max everything out to level 99. And continue to grind. Because I think they said there's going to be DLC once the game's all said and done. So this is just a side mission. That's pretty easy stuff. Every side mission. Now, there's these orbs that you have to find throughout the game. And some I missed. I had to go back and look up a guide to find them, because they're kind of off the beaten path. Especially some of the later levels. They're not that they're difficult, like, because they're pretty linear. But there's, like, this other path to follow, and I just kind of forgot about it. So I had to go back and check it all out. Soul Burst, these are just basic abilities to use, weapon ability, defeat a cat, yeah. Of course, you get the classic enemies like Cactuar and Tonberry and all that, Anima Shard, so you find these, and instead of, like, using each job class, you can just use the Anima Shard to level up job classes that you don't like to use. Anima Crystal is a more powerful version than Anima Shard. Artifact is, it's like a more powerful weapon. I got that as a drop. Job Crest. So it's just all stuff like leveling up, unlock every panel, a swordsman. So pretty simple stuff. Now the master rank, that's leveling up to level 99, and you just gotta grind and get a million anima crystals, and I just did that for the warrior. All the jobs, the dark knight. So I use the paladin and the sage were my jobs that I liked using. The ninja, assassin, liberator, breaker, void knight, tyrant, sage, and the cyclic warrior, which you unlock after beating the game. So let's just log in here. I'm going to show you where I grinded for anima crystals, if anyone's looking for that. I found this online, and this just seems like the easiest for me. And I'll just show you some of the combat and, you know, how my Jack avatar looks. You want to kind of use it to get high job affinity, but towards the end, I didn't really give a shit because I just kept going to the same area over and over again. And I will say, all the boss fights in this game are very, very challenging. Like, I think I died at every boss fight at least once. I mean, shit, with Tiamat, I think I died like either 10 or 15 times. That was so difficult because once you get Tiamat to the second phase, it can regenerate. It's like, oh my god, man. Unbelievable. But I played on normal difficulty throughout the whole game. So, and then you'll unlock Chaos. So here it is in Chaos. Let's see, it's been a while since I fucking played this game, so I gotta remember the controls. So, let's see, how's my Jack look? I have him with the hat. He looks like a badass with the hat on. Doesn't he? So, we'll go into, this is where I grind. Against, this right here. And you gotta fight the Marlboro. And you get a bunch of anima crystals. And see how it says Dimension 10 there? So each area you're in this game, this is actually modeled off of Mount Gagazet, this world. And Dimension 10 for Final Fantasy 10. Each area is modeled after a different world in Final Fantasy series. Like for Final Fantasy 7, you have the Mako Reactor. For Final Fantasy 6, you fight on the floating continent thing. Remember when the world was ending against Kefka and you fought the Ultima weapon? And you know, you had to wait to rescue Shadow. Like, you have that going on. So, I'm gonna avoid all these enemies just to show you. Fuck, I'm getting hit. See how much damage they do? It's fucking difficult, man. But I'll show you how I grind against Marlboro. And it's in this level here, which you saw me enter earlier. You gotta find this key. Which, where the fuck is it? It's over here, I think. There's a key to get through the next door. And then you just, there's the giant. So, the key's back here. I gotta remember. And just like the voice act in this game is fucking awesome. It's how they're all screaming. And especially towards the end, with Jack fighting the bosses, and just his screaming is unbelievable, man. Absolutely loved it. So yeah, the key's right here. I guess you could kill all these enemies, but the way to grind for this level to get the anima crystals is get the key really fast. I got the sage equipped. The music is fucking awesome, too. You hear the battle music right here? Absolutely incredible. And just pass by these guys, and then you fight the Marlboro, and the reason why you have the Sage equipped is, go over here, let's lock on, by Raga, we'll have them spam their attacks, boom, do it again, and then just keep wailing on them. Oh, get out of the way, oh, get out of the way, fuck, let's heal. And by Raga again. Boom. He's almost dead. And then press circle and he's fucking dead. Boom. Time's up. We can feed the Marlboro. And then just look at Jack with all the blood spattered on his face. You see that? Boom. What a badass. So I'll cut back to myself. So yeah, I absolutely love this game. This is the spoiler warning now, so if you haven't beat the game and you care about spoilers, you know, leave the video now. But the spoiler warning, I mean, I love the fact that Jack becomes Chaos, man, and essentially all the other characters, it makes sense, because, you know, Jack becomes Chaos, and the four others, you know, Jed, Ash, Sophia, and Neon all become the Warriors of, or actually they become the Fiends, rather. And then it ends with, like, the Warriors of Light coming to face them, and just the whole plot twist, so you learn that you were sent there by the Lufenians to keep, like, the balance in order, and Ostos is a good guy, and it's like a sort of time loop going on, which sort of harkens back to the original Final Fantasy, where there was a time loop with Chaos or whatever, if I remember correctly. It's been a while since I played that game. But it harkens back to that, and like it makes you sympathetic for a character who was a villain in the original game, Ostos the Dark Elf, and he's my favorite character in the whole game. Like, I love too when he's like, oh, you'll just forget about me, Jack. No, it is what it is. And then, like, when you face him, he turns into the ultimate weapon. It's fucking awesome. It's Kino. And, you know, great voice acting. Like, especially when in the end there, Jack has to kill all his party members. And he becomes Chaos. And he gets, like, this distorted voice where he sounds, you know, like, possessed by Chaos. And he's going against the Lufenians, destroying all the crystals. And his great quotes, too, when he's fighting, I think it's against Licht. And it's like, I am Licht. I don't give a fuck who you are! And he punches him. Even early on, too, when he first meets Neon, and she starts talking to him, he goes, bullshit! And he puts in headphones and starts, like, rocking out to... People are saying it's Limp Bizkit. I don't think it's Limp Bizkit. I just think it's, you know, some generic rock song. But, you know, even meeting... like, the dialogue... every time Jack spoke, I was laughing my ass off. Like Ossus is telling him, like, giving him a lore dump. Just tell us about the crystals, you know? And, all the quotes at the end, too, when he's going against the Lufenians, like, you think you can play God? I'll take your power and show you the true meaning of chaos! I'll kill every last one of you! And, like, as he's doing his final attacks against the final boss, it's like, this is for Jed and Ash and Neon and Sophia! For all of them! For Ostos, too, so his dream can come true! Fucking awesome, and absolutely loved it. I very much enjoyed the game. Now, this game is turned into a major flop. I don't think it sold very well, because normally they tell you if, you know, it sold well. Triangle Strategy just said we sold a million copies or something like that. We haven't heard anything about this, so it hasn't even sold a million copies. So I guarantee you this summer it'll be on sale for like $30. If you're still waiting for it, you know, pick it up. I think you'll have a great time playing it. But I think a lot of people were filtered by either the trailer or just, you know, seeing reviews. A lot of the reviewers didn't like the Jack character, the over-the-top dialogue, you know, the combat. I enjoyed the combat, but a lot of people were like, oh, the combat sucks. I like the game. I'm happy I got it. I'm happy I got this hat, which, you know, normally in my videos I wear the hat backwards because I feel like you can't see my face when I'm wearing it forwards. When I'm out in public, I always wear hats forward, but, you know, it's got like a shadow. I don't know. Kind of weird. That's why I'm always wearing them backwards in these videos. But, got the hat. I wear this hat every day. And very much enjoyed the game. It'll be interesting to see if they remake other Final Fantasy games in the same vein, in that they sort of tell the origin story to those specific games. But I would like to see, like, a remake similar to, not to, like, Final Fantasy VII having multi-parts, but remake Final Fantasy VI in 3D with, like, voice acting and stuff. That'd be so badass. Or Final Fantasy IV. That'd be so fucking awesome. But I enjoyed this game so much. Great voice cast. I don't know who voiced Jack, but, like, looking at the voice cast... Shirami Lee, who is a great voice actress, voices Asuna in Sword Art Online, Lucy in Fairy Tail, among various other characters. She voices the princess, Princess Sarah. And then you also have Todd Haberkorn, who did great, man, as Ostos, who voices Natsu in Fairy Tail, Alan Walker in D.Gray-man. He was actually the villain, Truth, in my review, when I did my review of Eureka 7 Astral Ocean. He voiced the character there, so he's a great voice actor, and it's cool that they got those big talents for those characters. Although I don't know who voiced Jack. I'll figure out who voiced him real quick. So the voice actor for Jack is named Morcian Melvin, and I'm on IMDb right now. Let's see what else he's been in. Cause he did fucking awesome as Jack. He was in TV series as a narrator. Vengeance Killer Newlyweds. Narrator in When Big Things Go Wrong. He's a narrator in like all these things. He was in Robot Chicken in 2008. What the fuck? Where'd they find this guy from? Holy shit, he did so good as voice acting, man. As voice acting Jack, like a complete badass. I would have thought he'd been like in like anime series or something, but damn, he did a great job. I highly recommend this game. Like I said, though, check it out. Like, wait for a sale. I think it'll be on sale. I'm happy I got it at launch because I very much enjoyed playing it, and I'm happy I got the hat. But you know, for people who want to save a few bucks, I bet you it'll be on sale just because it's not selling well. So that's what Square does. Things always go on sale in the summer, I would imagine. But very much enjoying it. My next video game review is probably going to be Persona 5 Royal. I don't know when I'm going to beat that game. I've heard it's very long. I'm like 8 hours into it. So stay tuned for that review at some point. But otherwise, you know, we got the live streams of Final Fantasy X-2, which I'll continue tomorrow. So stay tuned for that. And I love this game. I had so much fun playing it. And hope you guys, if you played it, enjoyed it as well. So thanks for watching. Have a great day, and we'll see you guys later.